Good afternoon, everybody. I just wanted to come by today and give a quick testimony and a couple of words of encouragement. Now, I know we've all heard many, as I say, cliches that have been formulated from Bible scriptures, and I know that most of you are familiar with this one. By his stripes we are healed. And the problem I have with scripture being turned into loosely and frivolously used cliches is that the impact and the power and the strength of the Most High's word has become null and void in some sense, because people hear it so as matter-of-factly so often that it starts to lose any meaning at all in most people, and they don't believe it, and they don't give it the true conviction and strength that it should have. When we use the Father's word, we have to use it in sincerity. We have to use it in truth. We have to use it in true faithfulness with belief and strength so that that power of it can manifest itself. Here's something that happened to me last week. My back had been hurting me, which is typical when you work and you do physical labor on top of everything else. There's a tendency for you to have back problems from time to time, back aches and muscle spasms and stuff like that. Many of you are familiar with that. But mine had been bothering me for at least a good week or so, and it's nothing major. We get used to those tweaks and pains. But on this particular night, my back was really giving me a major problem. I was having a muscle spasm on my right side about halfway down, and if I would turn a little bit or I would reach, it would just, the pain would be so intense that it would almost, and I say almost, bring a tear to your eye. It was that bad, and then it would just radiate through half of my body, so it was really painful. But you know, I persevered through and tolerated the pain because I'm gonna do what I have to do. So I went to work, and it just caused me problems. When I made my return trip from the run I was on, when I got back, I went to reach for the door, and it just locked up in that intense pain again, and I just sat back down, and I just closed my eyes, and I prayed to the Most High, and I said, Father, I said, I thank you. I didn't ask, and I'll tell you why. I said, Father, thank you for healing me, because I know all things are possible with you, and you've already done them, and I thanked them. And I prayed for about, you know, a minute or so, and the time I opened my eyes and then reached for the door again, my back pain was gone, instantly gone. And over the past few days, it's just gotten better and better. My point being is, when we pray to the Father, we have to do it in sincerity, and we have to do it in true faith and belief in Him and His Word. But with healing in particular, people don't generally or truly believe that He will heal us unless they see miraculous things happen. Healing does not have to be a miracle. He has already provided the healing for us. We have to learn to stake claims to the promises and things that He has already done and said that He has given to us. We have to stop asking for what He has already given to us. Now, how do we receive or claim these promises? In obedience, in faith, in devotion, in all these things. And just thank Him for them. He's already done them. And then we have to patiently allow them to manifest themselves, because all things are going to be done in His time and not ours. In Isaiah 53 and verse 5, it reads, but He was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised or broken for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon Him, and with His stripes we are healed. It didn't say we will be healed or we may be healed. It says we are healed. He already went through this. He was already broken for us, for our sins, for our transgressions. And with that, with Him going through that, our healing has been accomplished. So what was left for us to do? Recognize what He has already done and stake hold and claim that gift, that reward, that promise, in this case, that healing. So when you're going through stuff, because many of us, we go through aches and pains and problems, and we never give the Father an opportunity to fulfill the promises that He has made to us. Because what? Because we're impatient, we get frustrated, we're intemperate, and just all these things. And we just run off to man, or we just murmur and complain and suffer and murmur and complain. And we don't ever just acknowledge what the Father has already done for us and promised to us, and let Him do His work. Stake claim to the promise and let Him work. Now 2 Peter 2:24 reads like this: Who His own self bare our sins in His own body on the tree, that we, being dead to sins, should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes ye were healed. So by His sufferings we were healed, and we have been healed. So once again, people, He's done these things for us, and it says that we have to what? 2 Peter 2:24, dead to sins. We have to be living right. We have to be being obedient and doing His will. And when we call upon the promises and the gifts and the things that He has already done for us, they will fulfill themselves. See, He's not going to just give all these things to us because He's already done them for us. We have to claim them. We claim them by asking or acknowledging, and we claim them by being obedient and faithful and trust in Him and not murmuring and complaining. So trust in the Most High, study His Word, understand what He is already telling us He's done, and stake claim to the promises that He's already given us. This is Brother Lloyd. I'm out.